All right, now everybody, as we conclude this press conference, I have the wonderful, wonderful joy of celebrating another great New Yorker. We've been doing this over these last few weeks, and it is making me prouder every single day of this city. Incredible people that have come out of the city and changed the world in so many ways. I want to talk about someone who he has changed the world with his incredible skill as an actor, a director. He's changed the world as someone who gave back to the city he loves and gave back to our first responders. But he also changed my world and my whole team's world, because when I was starting out, he's one of the people who lent not just a hand, but a tremendous support and kindness and encouragement, and helped our whole team get here to City Hall and make an impact. And I'll talk about his achievements, but I think something especially fun to do would be to look back to the year 2014. We were getting ready for the Inner Circle show, which I know our colleagues in the media look forward to coming back live in 2022. It was the first one I was going to do, and I had to get ready because I'd never done an Inner Circle show. I had to get ready. I needed a great drama coach. I needed someone who could prepare me for this grand performance. And this video you're going to see captures Steve Buscemi coaching me, preparing me for hopefully acting greatness. Let's look at this video. Niles, I am never going to get this.
No, it looks great. You're
zip it, Niles.
Steve, what are you doing here?
You are in crisis mode, my friend. Inner Circle.
Inner Circle crisis mode.
Coming up.
Yeah.
Right? You want to be in shape.
We're doing great, Steve. We don't...
What do you think got Dinkins to sing? What do you think got Bloomberg to dance? What do you think put Rudy in that dress?
You?
In a way.
Never mind. Come on, we got work to do.
All right.
Hands up. Right? Hands are always moving.
It's kind of improv, isn't it?
Yeah. Unique New York.
Unique New York.
Unique New York.
Unique New York.
Just try doing this. It might be helpful if you think of yourself as an animal. Good. Let me see you do a monkey.
He eats pizza with a knife and fork, and they call me a dummy.
Okay, I'm seeing your lips move a lot. I'm as light as a feather. I'm as light as a feather. Can you go another 30?
Yeah.
Okay, now you lose the feather.
I'm as light as a feather.
A little higher. Yeah.
Those municipal labor contracts you need to sign, Mr. Mayor?
It's easy now, right?
Just a second.
What? Niles, you're killing me here.
I can't help it. I'm your mother.
That was good.
Really?
Yes.
He's pizza. He's pizza with
a... He eats pizza with a knife and fork, and they call me a dummy?
One of the all-time greatest, Steve, amongst your many dramatic achievements. This guy, I have to say, and this is the whole truth, we live in the same neighborhood in Brooklyn. I knocked on his door one day when I was running for city council, and I didn't realize it was him until he was standing in front of me, and that began, in the most wonderful of ways, a friendship. And I got to know Steve as a human being. He's a famous guy, yes, but I got to know him as a human being and a member of our neighborhood. And I got to know his story. And he started out as someone who just was looking for a way forward in New York City, became a firefighter, engine company, 55, serving Little Italy in the 1980s. And his incredible talent emerged, and he became just one of the great actors of our time, an incredible storyteller. And you could think of him for the extraordinary comedic work he's done. You could think of him for Boardwalk Empire and so many other. Talk about range, dude. But I have been moved by not only the friendship that I've experienced, but the love he feels for so many people in the city, and particularly for our first responders. After 9/11, he was there for people, felt a tremendous bond to our firefighters in particular. After Sandy, we walked together in Breezy Point, the devastation after Hurricane Sandy. You were there for that community. Steve, no matter what you do, how famous you become, you always come back to your love for this place and your love for the people who serve us. And I got to tell you, your heart, your soul, your feet are on the ground always. It has moved me every single time. And this is one of the last things I get to do as mayor. But it's sort of, this is talk about full circle. I was so special the day I knocked on that door in 2001. Here we are 20 years later, brother.
Yeah.
It's been a long road for both of us. But I can't thank you enough for what you've done for this city. And it is my tremendous honor on behalf of the people of the city to present you to the key, with the key to New York City.
Wow. That's amazing. Thank you. Here it is.
You should get it just for drama coaching.
Okay. You know, you're a natural. I think you should.
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
Yes, yes.
I'm going to think about that.
Some casting ideas.
Yeah, okay.
I did write some remarks. It'll only be about 40 minutes. No, but I just want to say this is such an honor to be here with you today and to receive this, to have... friends and family here. Karen, thank you for being here today. My brothers, Michael and Kenneth. We are New Yorkers. Our parents were both born in Brooklyn, Bay Ridge, in East New York. All my brothers live in New York City. We're spread out, Brooklyn, Manhattan, Staten Island. My mom is there too. Our dad was a sanitation worker for 30 years. Kenneth worked for the MTA for 30 years. Michael, who is also a really fine actor, he's been in more New York City productions than I can count. And although he's not a politician, he is the unofficial mayor of Red Hook. Did you know that?
That's pretty good.
Just
Mr.
ask
Mayor.
Anybody on Van Brunt Street, they all know him. New York City, it's where I met my late wife, Jo Andres, who you know was an incredible filmmaker, painter, performance artist and friend. We met when we were both living in the East Village back in the 80s, you know, doing performance work. We got married right here in City Hall. And when we had our son Lucian, we moved to Park Slope, became Bill's neighbor, and we raised our son there. And he now lives in LA. You can't win them all.
Oh, man.
But every year...
You just harshed our buzz.
But every year on his birthday, I send him a pizza from Luigi's in Sunset Park, and he eats it with his hands. He does not use a knife and fork. Just saying.
Just saying.
New York City is where I learned how to be an actor, you know, doing theater and independent film. You were kind enough to mention some of the productions. Just a little trivia point. One year in the late 80s, I had a very New York year. I appeared in the films New York Stories, King of New York, and Slaves of New York, not to mention Bloodhounds of Broadway. Did you see that one?
I missed
all
that
right.
One.
Come on, you got to keep up. But before being an actor, I had one of the greatest jobs in the city, as you know, at Engine 55 in Little Italy. And I'll always be grateful to them for allowing me to work beside them in the aftermath of 9/11. This city has been through a lot over the years, and we've been through it together. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we always get through it by working together and supporting each other. And that's one of the things I love most about this city is the people. You know, it's their energy, the passion, spirit, and love. And, Bill, I want to thank you and Charlene and your whole administration for the dedicated service and the major accomplishments of the past 8 years. And I do believe that the reforms and the initiatives that of your tenure, it will benefit this city for years and years to come. And as a New Yorker, I'm grateful for that. And, you know, as New Yorkers, it's up to all of us, you know, to keep this city great and to make it a better place always. When I was a kid, I would only see Key to the City ceremonies, you know, on TV or in movies. And to think that now I'm in movies, but this is not a movie. This is real, right?
This is real.
This is real.
This is actually happening.
I'm getting the Key to the City. If this was a movie, my character would not be getting a Key to the City. He'd be stealing the Key to the City, trying to make it work. anyway, this is just such an incredible honor. I never could have imagined in a million years that I would receive this honor and that one day I would count the city, the mayor of the city of New York as a friend. Thank you, brother. This means the world to me. And thank you. Thank you to all. Appreciate it.
Brother, you're all heart and soul. And you do take some curious choices of roles.
Yes.
Okay. Let's say not every one of your characters is an admirable civic figure.
Okay.
Although Nucky is a very, very capable, let's say that.
Civic-minded, you know.
Yeah.
But, well, okay.
In his own way.
Yes, yes.
But I wanted to say something about you maintains an optimism. I've always noticed this. Even though you play often characters who maybe have tougher personas, you always have an optimism. And I wanted you to tell people, especially after everything we've been through these last couple of years, mm-hmm. what keeps you hopeful?
Well, I mean, look, we are going through a tough time right now, and it's been this way, you know, for the last couple of years. But it really is, I think it's the people who are from here and who come here. You know, I always give a lot of credit to people who come here from far away. I mean, I was born in Brooklyn, but I was, you know, raised in Long Island. And that was like a world, I was worlds away. Coming into the city, it was so intimidating. But once you're here and you, it's the people. It's the people that you meet and that help you along the way and that you get to help along the way. That to me, that's the spirit of New York City. And that's what I guess keeps me optimistic because I've seen us go through hard times. I remember, you know, I mean, pre-9/11, you know, we know what the city was like in the 60s and the 70s, and we've come a long way, and we still have a lot of work that has to be done, of course, there's always work to be done here. And, but if we, you know, if we band together, I really believe that we could do anything.
I love that. I love that. All I can say is there's different ways of inspiring, and every time just your humanity, your sense of just something good in people comes through. And it's real interesting. I think it creates this kind of virtuous loop because you send a signal to people that something's okay.
Well, I'm glad if that's true. I mean, I'm so privileged to work with, you know, our friend Nancy Carbone, who does
yes.
Friends of Firefighters. You know, I feel like I just, you know, lend myself. It's like it's all these other people that are doing the great work, you know, that ask me maybe to be a part of it. And so it's easy for me to step in and be supportive. But I really give it up to the people who are really doing it every day and, you know, to make people's lives better.
Well, I will say, final point, you, there's a lot of ways you've made lives better, but sometimes it's just the sheer kind of comic insanity of some of the roles you've taken on.
Mm-hmm.
And I just want to make sure, because people know, of course, a lot of your very famous works, but I want to make sure everyone goes back and looks at the role you played in Portlandia.
Oh, Portlandia. I thought you were going to say Spy Kids, because you used to...
Well, Spy Kids.
Compliment me on that one line.
That one? Okay.
Oh, go ahead.
Let's do both.
Portlandia. No, no. I want to hear. No, this is good.
Well, no. I'll go from the sacred to the profane.
Okay.
The sacred is the line from Spy Kids. And I'm like, how did you end up in Spy Kids on top of everything else? When you are the kind of mad scientist who creates
yeah.
the miniature animals.
Yeah.
And I think I went with our kids.
Yeah.
So I'm watching the movie like, ah, here's a kids movie. And the mad scientist looks off into space at one point, your character, and says, do you think God stays in heaven because he fears what he's created here on earth?
Yeah.
And I just like, wait a minute. You know, like that's a deep line. So I have often quoted that back to you.
Yeah, you said it to me and I was like, oh, I did say that, didn't I?
Yeah.
It's like
pretty amazing.
Yeah.
Powerful, yeah. deep meaning there. But from the sacred to the profane. Portlandia,
yeah.
where you played the spokesman and representative of the celery industry.
Yes.
I think that is one of your great unsung moments.
Thank you so much.
I hope now the audience will go out and look up that segment. And I remember you were,
I think you were up against kale, and kale was the trendy thing, and celery was going.
Celery's a tough sell. It's a tough sell.
Celery's a tough sell.
You have to be committed.
Yeah.
But people should, you know. Park Bench. You were an early guest on Park Bench.
I was.
We filmed here.
Yes.
And how about the Vampire Weekend spot that we did?
This is Vampire Weekend video.
Before you.
Which
were
was
there.
That was that your first music video you directed?
That was yeah. That was
I would and I you know.
You met the boys and you inspired them, yes.
It was my honor. So you can see a rich cultural history here. Everyone, this is such a beautiful thing to be able to honor. People have done so much good. And Steve is just one of my all-time favorites, what he's done for the city and who he is. So Steve Buscemi, God bless you. God bless you, brother.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. Thank you.